support to the statement of my colleague, Senator Panfilo Lacson. I'm uncomfortable with this because this is a public trial, this is a trial, and this is a people's court. It is a process by which the people are actually judging for themselves through what they see. And if we are to have a public trial, yet the evidence will not be available to the public, then it would defeat the purpose. However, I do not want to engage in any debate with my distinguished colleague from Makati, Senator Arroyo. I just would like to manifest my support with the view of Senator Lacson. Thank you, Mr. President.
The gentle lady from Taguig.
Thank you. Mr. President, I believe there is no disagreement among the senators. I think we can reconcile the views. We simply have to distinguish between the presentation or the marking of the evidence and the formal offer of evidence. When we are just in the marking stage, by all means, this should not be paraded. And I beg to disagree when the statement is made that this has not been released. Perhaps it has not been distributed to the public, but the news will bear me out that it is shown like this by spokespersons. I don't know how close up that goes, and I do not know if after that it is released, because I have reports that it is circulating in the internet. And there's a big difference between documents that have been marked and have been offered. And I totally agree that this is a public hearing, that the public should be well informed, that we should not hide anything. In fact, I'm not aware that we have any provisions for executive session, but there is a big difference between deceiving the public and making it appear that these have already been formally offered, when in fact they have only been marked. And these are fine distinctions that lawyers or members of the Senate judges will be able to determine at the proper time. But to use it at a time in media when it has only been marked is deceiving the public, Mr. President.
Anyway,
where the ruling should come in.
Thank you. Anyway, the chair has cautioned the two sides of this proceeding, adversarial proceeding, the prosecution and the defense, to exercise caution. You know, in other countries, when you are going to publicize a case, a criminal case especially, and it is inordinately discussed in public, it could be a basis for a mistrial, which of course is not a part of our system of criminal procedure. But nonetheless, there is a purpose for this caution, because we must not unnecessarily create an impression in the minds of the public that this is already an admitted evidence. Not yet. It is only being presented. The minority floor leader.
Thank you, Mr. Presiding Officer. Sir Presiding Officer, if we look at Rule 18, at all times while the Senate is sitting upon the trial of impeachment, the doors of the Senate shall be open to the public. Silence shall be observed by the visitors at all time on pain of eviction from trial venue. The Presiding Officer and the members of the Senate shall refrain from making any comments and disclosure in public pertaining to the merits of the pending trial. The same shall likewise apply to the prosecutors, to the persons impeached, and to their respective counsels and witnesses. I read this rule in support of all those who stood before me. Senator Joker Arroyo is correct that just because it's a trial and it's open, that doesn't mean that we violate people's rights. But Senator Lacson is correct in pointing out that we have to suspend our rules if we want to go in an executive session. But we all agreed when we made the rules that we should in fact put everything before the people, ilantad lahat po ito para walang magsuspecha kung ano magiging desisyon, kung ano ang mga ebidensya. Pero, Mr. President, I'd like to point out two things. First, our witness here has been very careful and has followed her oath and her work very well. By nung present po yung alpha list ng Supreme Court, sinabi naman po niya na may ibang names doon. Kaya ang ginawa po niya, hindi niya inilabas para makita yung ibang mga pangalan. And there were times in the past, no, that this was also the discussion, no? And in fact, we've been discussing kung halimbawa maglalabas ng mga titulo na may mga ibang pangalan dito, kailan pwedeng madamay yung ibang tao because it's necessary in the trial at kailan hindi. So I agree with the presiding officer to exercise caution and let's just simply follow the law. In the case of the ITR of the Chief Justice, the President has already authorized its release. And if it is brought up in the trial, the cameras here are very powerful. They can zoom in anytime and see it for themselves. But let me make the second point very briefly, Your Honor. I keep reading in the newspapers a gag rule. And I think they're referring to the second and third paragraph I read. Let me just point out that there's a difference between a sub judice rule and a gag rule. Because a gag rule is absolute. Ang ibig sabihin nga ng gag, eh, tatakpan mo yung bibig, no, in layman's term. At hindi pwede magsalita anything and everything about that case. Yung sub judice ay meron certain parameters. For example, if you are simply narrating or detailing what was in the complaint or what happened today or what it was in the answer, or if you are part of the media or the spokesman and you are simply recapping or showing both sides. That's why if you look at the words, nakalagay refrain. Hindi nakalagay dito na absolutely wag magsalita ang prosecution or judges. But sa judges, mas maingat kami sapagkat mai-interpret na kinakampihan namin ang isang side pag nagsalita kami. So, Mr. President, let me just agree with my colleagues here and let me agree with you. Let's just be very careful. Let's not be too excited that in coming out with the evidence, whether for the prosecution or the defense, we violate and trample upon people's rights. But so far, our witnesses have been very careful, from the clerk of the Supreme Court to the BIR commissioner. Thank you, Mr. President.
Yeah. Perhaps, Mr. President, the final word from Senator Joger Arroyo. May you recognize
the gentleman from Makati and Bicol.
Mr. President, I don't want to belabor the point. I started this soon. We have rules, and rules are designed so that everyone would follow the rule. The rule is simple, that any evidence that is identified or marked is not yet evidence. It is nothing but a piece of paper. When will it be a public document? When it is admitted. When it is admitted, then it becomes a public document. The Internal Revenue Code is very strict in this. About the Internal Revenue, the ITRs to be sacrosanct. As a matter of fact, Commissioner Henares would not have been here or brought those documents had not the President of the Philippines, no less, authorized the opening of those documents. The National Internal Revenue Code says that insofar as the ITR is concerned, the Commissioner must seek the permission of the President, which she said she did in writing. So, in other words, no matter how public our hearing is, the rules of secrecy must be followed. There is no exception to that. It is a public trial, but order must be maintained. Otherwise, it's no trial at all. That is the reason for this trial. A trial assumes order, system. If without it, then it's useless. That is all. I don't want to argue with anyone on that. I just want to call the attention so that henceforth we will follow the rules. Thank you, Mr. President.
And I would like to state for the record that that was precisely the reason why what the chair cautioned the private prosecutor not to go into the substance of the document, meaning the contents, because the Commissioner of Internal Revenue was brought here to testify on the documents that she brought and whether they were unauthentic documents, meaning that they have conformed with the formal requirements of the statute and to present those documents, because those documents are the best evidence of the contents, whether there is any income tax or income reported and whether taxes were paid. There's no better evidence than the income tax, of course, in the supporting receipts. No? So I hope we will adhere to these rules so that we can move into the trial smoothly. No, I could not object to the questions relating to the substance because I'm the presiding officer. So, but I cautioned. The record will show that the chair cautioned the private prosecutor in delving into the contents of the documents that were presented by the Commissioner of Internal Revenue. In fact, even the alpha list, I said the best evidence of the alpha, the contents of the alpha list is the alpha list itself. So with that, now I would like to hear the pleasure of the defense counsel.
Thank you, Your Honor.